a COVID testing mess in San Francisco. The city had to cut its hours and then an outage forced sites to completely shut down. This all comes as thousands rush to get swabbed and as the state's positivity rate continues to skyrocket. Here's a look at the numbers. The 7-day positivity rate now stands at more than 22%. KPIX 5's Andria Borba is live in San Francisco with more on what went wrong today. Andria?
Well, Elizabeth, today was supposed to be the beginning of temporary reduced testing capacity and hours at city-run sites here in San Francisco. But a software glitch moved the testing from slow in San Francisco to completely non-existent by the end of the afternoon.
The warning signs of trouble brewing began early at the City of San Francisco COVID-19 testing sites.
When I got here, their system was down, so the line was kind of long. But once the system came up, started moving very quickly.
The Department of Public Health sites, operated by Color Labs, were already facing reduced hours due to staffing shortages. Employees that were supposed to be running sites and processing nasal swabs in a lab were sick themselves. But at 2:10 p.m., gates closed across the city. The problem, intermittent outages with Color's patient registration and sample collection software. In a statement, Color said, "We will restore service at these locations as soon as possible. For anyone whose appointments were postponed today, Color will be in touch with alternative testing options." District 6 Supervisor Matt Haney says there needs to be more testing hours and better guidance from the San Francisco Department of Public Health.
If the Department of Public Health is telling you if you feel sick or you've been exposed, get tested, but you can't get a test, that's a huge problem because it's creating a tremendous amount of anxiety, uncertainty, panic even, where people are showing up at emergency rooms, they're calling 911.
Residents reliant on those testing sites say with another winter surge upon us, this is the moment city and Color officials should have been prepared for.
It's kind of sad. I know that Omicron is like spreading really bad and it's affecting a lot of level of industry, so I definitely feel like that's really disappointing. I definitely feel the city should really have kept up with that.
So, Andria, how long is the city's testing capacity going to be impacted by all this? Will they be back up and running tomorrow, do you think?
Well, in a statement, Elizabeth, Color said that their engineers are actively working on this software problem and they hope to get service returned to those testing sites as soon as possible. As for the capacity and staffing issues from DPH, they said it was only temporary, but of course there was no end date given as to when that temporary status might end.
Sure, they don't know who's going to test positive next and what their staffing is going to look like.
Exactly.
All right, Andria, thank you.